Adam, good day to everyone. Whether it's day or night, wherever you're watching, I'm Jewel, and this is J7409 weather. On today, Tuesday, the 13th of August, 2019. If you're new here and you're into the weather, please don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to ensure you get all the latest in weather news, forecasts, watches, warnings, and any kind of tropical weather that may develop. What's going on today? Well, we do have some very severe weather that's going to pop up in portions of the U.S. and hot temperatures. Those are the two main things going on in today's weather. I'll have that and much more all coming up on checking out the severe weather for today. I want to get right on to this because some folks could have some very severe weather today. This is the categorical outlook for the lower 48 and the scattered to severe thunderstorms. They're looking like, folks, for the most part, they're expected across the southern mid-Atlantic into the Tennessee Valley and across the central high plains. Now, you can see over here in Virginia, a very high chance is up to a number 3. This is enhanced right for the Virginia area going up maybe into parts of Maryland. Folks, be aware. Then, it's still a good chance down the borderline of Virginia, going over into West Virginia, parts of Kentucky, parts of Tennessee, and parts of North Carolina, as well as when we move westerly just a tad over in Nebraska, Kansas, Colorado area. Everybody in the green, it doesn't matter if it's light green or dark green, you do have a chance of a thunderstorm to pop up. It's this time of the year, so be aware of your skies. Now, when I talk about this severe weather that may happen, is there any tornado chances in this today? And how much of a chance? It's looking like the greatest chance of tornadoes is at 5% over in the corner of Kansas, Nebraska, and Colorado. It's at 5%. All the rest that you see is 2% up here in Wisconsin and in lower southern Minnesota. That's just at 2%. So far, there's really not any chance of tornadoes over in this area. It may change as the day goes along. If it does, I'll be sure and put it up. But wind, the wind is going to be something. Look at this, 30%. Over in Virginia and going up into the Maryland area, looking like right in here, this could cause problems. This could cause some power outages. This could cause some trees to fall. This could cause some damage. And this is looking like, with the wind up this high, microburst. It doesn't have to be a tornado to do tornado damage. They don't last as long, they don't cover as much territory, but where microbursts occur, it is just as devastating as a tornado. So please, if you're in this red area here, be aware. Also, the 15% area over in Kansas and Colorado, also wherever it's 15 and especially where it's 30, where this 5% is a hit and miss chance. What about hail? Do we have any? Yes, it's looking like there's a very enhanced chance of large hail falling if these storms occur like they look like they're going to over in parts of Kansas and Nebraska and Colorado. Up to a 15% chance. Other than that, panhandle of Oklahoma and Texas is just at 5%, and then of course Wisconsin and southern Minnesota and a little bit of northern Iowa, eastern northern Iowa, you just have a 5% chance of some hail today. So please be aware of this. Now, as we look at thunderstorm activity on the European model for today, this is around lunchtime today. These storms could start before lunch in places, but they should continue throughout today, off and on all day into this evening and tonight. Now, this is around lunchtime today, as I said. As we move up to this evening around 7 p.m., you can see how these storms are going to spread. And of course, the darker they are, the bigger chance that they have of doing damage. Now, when we move up to early morning hours tomorrow, around 2 a.m. in the morning, you can see right up in here, these are looking like severe thunderstorms. So we'll move along to 2 p.m. tomorrow afternoon. It all starts all over again and starts spreading even more. And we'll go to 10 p.m. tomorrow night. So folks, it looks like these storms are going to occur. There may be more than even show up on this map. There may be a little less, but wherever they occur, you can expect high winds, and especially over in this area, large hail to accompany them. So please watch your skies and stay safe. Now the hot, hot temperatures. I'm going to show you a couple of places here, and then I'll just go to the map and show you in general. But here we have portions of Tennessee. This is from Memphis right here. And you can see right here, it's going to be dangerous heat and humidity today. And they're even telling people, if you have outdoor activities planned for today, especially if you have to work outside, please do it and take a lot of breaks. It should be limited or either postpone to another day. Look at this. Memphis going to feel like 114. Over close to Jackson, 112. Everybody up in this area is going to feel like it's 112 to 114. So please be aware. It goes right on over to Paris and then down in these areas here into Mississippi. There's Tupelo. You can see at 113. It's going to be a very, very hot day, so please be aware of what's going on. And another place is down around the panhandle of Florida, up into Alabama. This is going to be something for you folks. 110 to 115 today. Excessive heat warning. This is going to last until 7 p.m. this evening. Those were just a couple examples that I showed you, but everywhere that's in this fuchsia color purple, even over here into parts of Arizona and California, up here in Louisiana, Arizona, going over, of course, into Alabama and a large portion of Mississippi, you are under this excessive heat warning. It's going to be extra, extra hot today. Wherever you see the orange, that is a heat advisory. It will be hot, but not quite as hot as these other places. So people, you need to take this into consideration and be aware. Please drink lots of water and wear light clothing. Stay safe. Check on your neighbors and check on your pets. And wrapping it up as we check out the tropics, this is from the National Hurricane Center. Nothing in the Atlantic or the Gulf for the next 5 days. And I'm going to go ahead and tell you, I see nothing during the next 10 days. Little systems might pop up, these little weather storms. But right now, I may change my tune. If it looks like something, you know, I'll let you know. But, you know, I see people, hurricane, hurricane. Well, yeah, it's hurricane season. And before hurricane season is over, there probably will be one. But there may not be because of the mojo going on over here. You know, the water is really, really hot, folks, especially down in here where all these little systems try to pop up and come across. Or either they get pulled down from systems coming off the Gulf or the East Coast and try to form into something. Just about every system that comes off the East Coast forms, but then it dies down. Over in this area, remember where Florence was? Florence was right over in here. Traveled clean across, right? And got me right up in here. But anyway, this area of the ocean is not that hot right now. It's like in the 60s and lower 70s. But when you come to south of this area, it's boiling hot, okay? It's hot, 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 hot. And this has nothing to do with HARP or anything else. This is just the way it is. And I'll try to make a video on it and explain it to you. But right now, everything's looking okay. If it changes, I'll be sure and let you know. Now, on the two-day outlook over here in the Central Pacific, it's well south of Hawaii. We do have this disorganized area, and it's about 880 miles south-southwest of the Big Island. It's a trough of low pressure. It does have a 30% chance of forming in 5 days. When we come over to the eastern North Pacific, look here, we still got Henrietta going on. Henrietta now has winds of 30 miles per hour. Henrietta is moving west-northwest to 13 miles per hour. And then we have this system that has a very good chance of forming in 5 days, up to 70%. As of now, it's still disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and it's located about 1,100 miles southwest of the southern tip of the Baja California Peninsula, and it's associated with an elongated trough of low pressure. And it's looking like in 2 days a 40% chance, and in 5 days a 70% chance. So we really need to keep our eyes on this and see where it goes and make sure that all of our friends in Hawaii stay safe. So other than that's what your weather's looking like for today. Please be safe in the heat, and when these storms pop up in severe areas I've showed you, please be aware and make sure you have a safe place to go. I love you all. I thank you all for everything you do for me so very much. It helps me more than you know just to make it, and I appreciate it so very much. Everyone have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day, and peace, love, and kindness to each of you. Thanks for watching.